Batavia, Ohio. The Brewer Excavating 316 of Joe Brewer on the outside. Out of Edinburgh, Indiana, the 14 of Joe Gotze. Row number 2 from Camden, Ohio, the 4G of Cody Evans on the outside. Was scheduled to be the 40 machine of Doug Pop. He's electing to start on the tail. That'll move the 17 from Columbus, Indiana, Nathan Vauder to the outside. Row 3, Roger Rourke from Flemingsburg. In the 11X of Jeff Herbert, here we go. Right off the bat, 3 wide as Cody Evans dives inside of Brewer. Gotze's going to take the lead down the backstretch. Joe Gotze's going to lead him off of turn number 4 the first time. So up front, Joe Gotze leads Cody Evans. Joe Brewer in third, Nathan Vauder in fourth. So out front, it is still Joe Gotze, our leader in the 14 machine. Cody Evans running in second. Joe Brewer holding on to that third spot. Battle for fourth, Nathan Vauder and Roger Rourke. Doug Pop and Herbert battling back in the pack, but Joe Gotze going to be closing on them rapidly. Halfway this time by for your leader, Joe Gotze. Again, Gotze going to be catching up to Herbert and Pop to put them a lap down. Battle back in Nathan Vauder and Roger Rourke battling. As that battle for fourth position heats up, Gotze gets past and puts Doug Pop and Herbert a lap down. Pretty torrid pace here in heat race number 1 for Joe Gotze out front. Roger Rourke has gotten past Nathan Vauder to take over that fourth position. A white flag waves from our flagman, Adam Bremer. And off of turn number 4, taking the checker flag out of Edinburgh, Indiana, the veteran, Joe Gotze with the win. Cody Evans comes home with a strong second place finish. Joe Brewer in third. Roger Rourke fourth. And Nathan Vauder will come home in fifth spot. But you're a winner. You got a lot of laps here to Speedway. A number of wins here at Moeller Raceway Park. And modifieds. And I run a lot of laps in the late models as well. But Joe Gotze taking the win in heat race number 1. On the front row, apparently Rusty Yarger electing the tail, so Blake Naylor and Glenn Keaton Jr. will now start in row 2. Michael Hildebrand and Jim Couch in row number 3. And Rusty Yarger and Bill Sheets in row number 4. The Black 99 of Tom Collini is actually not in this race. Late arriving machine, he's going to do one lap and pull off. Again, he was scheduled to be in heat race number 1. So we're going to give him a courtesy lap here at the tail, as it's not going to interrupt the rest of the event. He's going to do one lap and pull off with the 99 machine. Tom Collini was actually supposed to be in heat race number 1. So we're going to go 8 cars, 10 laps. How they finish determines how they start tonight's feature event. Chad Stapleton and John Whitney, two guys with a lot of laps. They currently sit 1 and 2 in the point standings here at Speedway. Stapleton jumps out to the lead. Whitney going to be right with him. All bottled up there behind him as Michael Hildebrand gets past 3 of them down the backstretch. Up front, Stapleton's your leader. Whitney now going to look underneath him down the backstretch. Top 2 cars right together. Little distance back to 3rd place running Michael Hildebrand. Bill Sheets now from the tail up to 4th place. Chad Stapleton now getting a couple of car lengths on Whitney. Again, Hildebrand up to 3rd. Bill Sheets in 4th. Blake Naylor into 5th position. Going to be half Raceway, this time by Chad Stapleton. That Raceway construction machine out front in Stapleton and Whitney. Very fast pace here in this heat race, similar to Joe Gotze in heat race number one, as they have caught up to the back of the pack. And you see Stapleton already putting a lap on Glenn Keaton Jr. Whitney still runs in second. Hildebrand in third. Bill Sheets into fourth spot. But your leaders already in heavy traffic here in heat race number two. So Stapleton working his way past Jim Couch, putting him a lap down. And again, John Whitney Jr. sits in second position, about four car lengths behind him. White flag's going to wave this time by. One lap remaining for your leader. So a checkered flag for Chad Stapleton, the driver out of Edinburgh, Indiana, the Raceway Construction Rogers Bar and Grill. It's a Club 29 race car. The 32 machine of Chad Stapleton takes the win. Stevens Heating and Cooling Ohio 1 machine of John Whitney comes home in the second spot. Michael Hildebrand out of Loveland, Ohio, comes home in third. Bill Sheets out of Versailles, Indiana, comes home in fourth spot. So again, these late models put a lot of time and energy and lots of money into their machines. We'll send them off with a wave lap. You'll see in the flag stand, they're going to be given the one to go sign, meaning we're going green next time. So wave to your favorite late model drivers. They'll wave back at you. They've been sitting patiently back in the pit area. We're going to go green. Joe Gotze and Chad Stapleton up front. Cody Evans, John Whitney in row two. Joe Brewer, Bill Sheets in row three. Roger Rourke, Michael Hildebrand in row number four. Nathan Vauder, Blake Naylor in row five. Doug Pop, Jim Couch in row six. Jeff Herbert, Rusty Yarger in row seven. Tom Collini and Glenn Keaton Jr. in row number eight. 25 laps the distance. Here we go. Green flag's going to wave. Joe Gotze and Chad Stapleton. Gotze leads them off of turn number two down the backstretch. Cody Evans, Chad Stapleton side by side into turn three. Gotze, our leader. Little contact between Bill Sheets and Brewer. Everybody keeps moving. We're staying green as Joe Brewer looks underneath of John Whitney as they battle for fourth. Joe Gotze, problems down the front stretch. Driver is okay, telling the safety crew, Doug Pop there, rolling that machine over. Very first night in a late model. And Doug Pop and Jim Couch get together down the front stretch, and Doug taking a tumble. Doug Pop there, so apparently that machine's not right. So Joe Gotze out front, Cody Evans second, Chad Stapleton, Joe Brewer, John Whitney, your top five. So Joe Gotze, the 14 machine out front. Cody Evans looking for his first career dirt win. He runs in second spot. And the green flag's going to wave. Again, Gotze out front, Evans second. Chad Stapleton trying to work the bottom of the racetrack. Gotze the leader, Cody Evans right there in his tracks. Top two cars running the high side of the racetrack. Next three running the bottom, but here comes Bill Sheets on the high side. Cody Evans now going to dive underneath of Joe Gotze, try and slide up in front of him off a two. Makes the clean pass. So Cody Evans out front. Gotze back to second. Joe Brewer working the bottom of the racetrack. He's up to third place now. Got a three-car battle for fourth. But up front, Cody Evans, and now the caution's going to wave. Coming back to the green flag, seven laps in. Joe Gotze gets a run, gets past Cody Evans, going to turn number one. Here comes Joe Brewer on the bottom. Up front, Joe Brewer now working the bottom of the racetrack. He's continuing to work his way forward. Joe Brewer started in fifth position. He's your new leader as he's working the bottom of the racetrack to perfection. Joe Brewer out front here in our late model feature. Still Brewer, our leader. Gotze runs in second. John Whitney now running the bottom of the racetrack with Brewer. Brewer excavating machine is out front. Joe Brewer, the leader, starting to stretch the lead out now. In the 316 machine, going to be halfway home this time by Joe Brewer out front. Still John Whitney in second. He's on the bottom of the racetrack. Joe Gotze in third, sticking to the high side. John Whitney now right on the back bumper of Joe Brewer. Going to be in some heavy traffic soon. That traffic is working on the bottom of the racetrack as well. Whitney looking to the high side of Brewer. They split the lap car coming down the front stretch, and John Whitney to the outside up front. Joe Brewer back to second. Meanwhile, Chad Stapleton working the bottom of the racetrack past Joe Gotze for third spot. Great race here in our late model feature. John Whitney out front. Joe Brewer second. Chad Stapleton in third. And Brewer makes contact with the G2 machine of Glenn Keaton. Keaton comes to a stop, and we've got debris all down the front stretch. So tough break for Joe Brewer in the 316 machine. He's going to pull off the racetrack. What a... So John Whitney, the veteran out front, Chad Stapleton, kind of started working the bottom of the racetrack as well right before that caution. So here we go, eight laps remaining. Green flag waves. So Whitney still out front. Chad Stapleton in second. Gotze in third. Michael Hildebrand with a nice run in fourth position in that 39 machine. Going to be five laps to go this time by. Joe Gotze now starting to put some pressure on Chad Stapleton for that second position. Meanwhile, Cody Evans, the four machine, going to pull off the racetrack. So tough break for Cody Evans. His race will end early in the 4G. Meanwhile, out front, John Whitney. And the 11 machine of Herbert going to pull to the infield. Laps winding down for John Whitney out front, the Ohio 1 machine. Figured a line out on the bottom of the racetrack. Coming to the white flag. One lap remaining. Still John Whitney out front. Chad Stapleton second, Joe Gotze in third. Checker flag waves for John Whitney. Stapleton going to hold on for second. Gotze in third. And a great run for Michael Hildebrand coming home in fourth spot. Roger Rourke coming home in fifth. The helmet's off. He's climbing out. Your winner, John Whitney. John, that was a pretty hard battle there as Joe Gotze's no stranger, and he had the top side working, and before you knew it, here comes Joe Brewer on the bottom, and you jumped down there, and away you went.
Yeah. You know, we took a big gamble. Everybody in the pits tonight was watching this racetrack. It had a ton of moisture in it, a big cushion up there. I think a lot of guys went with some soft tires, and we just gambled on everything. We just went ahead and tightened this thing up. And I kind of figured those guys had soft tires on, but what caught me off guard was Joe Brewer. And he was rolling, and I knew he had tougher stuff on. So I was kind of worried about Joe. And I'm not sure. Me and him got together. I think I might have come down on him a little bit. But he's got that car rolling pretty good. So we feel fortunate to get a win.
There he is, your winner tonight, John Whitney.